In this video, we are going to find out if poison ivy is actually poisonous in the winter. I've read so many articles that warn me that it still is, but I am skeptical. So today, I'm going to put my body on the line for science. You know, now that I read that out loud, it kind of sounds a little bit hyperbolic, doesn't it? I mean, the worst that's going to happen is I'm just going to get a rash, right? Anyway, I have conducted a series of experiments to thoroughly test out this claim, and the first one started at the end of my last video. All right, you're all watching, and there we go. So, getting the bud on my left forearm. That's it. Dosing myself with poison ivy, toxicodendron radicans. So now, it's time to unveil what actually happened. Okay, so it's been about a week now. Time to find out if anything happened. Moment of truth. Here is my left arm. Anything on it? No, nothing at all. No reaction whatsoever. And then on my right side, same thing. See that? There is nothing. I had absolutely no reaction on either of my arms. So that would mean that, you know, perhaps the hairs are not poisonous in the wintertime, and perhaps the buds are also not poisonous in the wintertime. But I'm gonna try one more thing to see if we can make this happen. I'm committed to this, to testing this out. Okay, you can see on this one right here, if I zoom in a little bit, that we have a lot more of the bark exposed. So maybe the bark will have more of the oil that's gonna cause the reaction. Who knows? We're gonna find out. And I'm not gonna be ginger with it this time. It's almost like a back scratcher from my arm here. Not gonna avoid it whatsoever. I know this is dumb, but I do think that, you know, I'm not gonna get that harmed from it. It's just gonna be a reaction if anything happens. And I think this is good to know. I think this information is important. It's not just, you know, out of stupid curiosity. I'm gonna try one more over there on my other arm. Here's the other one. So this one's gonna be with my right arm right here. And yeah, cause I just feel like the hairs should be the thing that causes the greatest reaction. And maybe I just didn't rub it enough the first time. And here, just want to show you guys, there's the redness on that arm, and there's the redness right there on this arm. So I'm telling you, I really do want to give this as fair of a shot as I possibly can, so that we can, you know, as definitively as possible from one test, find out if this is going to happen or not. And it's funny too, you know, the first time that I did it, I really could have sworn that I was feeling kind of like a bit of burning on my arms, a bit of itchiness, but you know, psychosomatics does play a role in this. I might have just been perceiving, like, or thinking that I should be feeling that, and then so it kind of comes up. But of course, I don't think that I can psychosomatic my way into actually having a reaction or not. So I'm excited about this. We'll give it another few days, and I'll check back with you guys, and we'll find out what happened. Okay, let's go ahead and cut right to it. Nothing. Once again, absolutely no reaction whatsoever. So, at this point, what have we tested? We've tested the hairs, we've tested the buds, we've tested the bark. None of those cause a reaction on me. And remember, like I said before, I know that I react to poison ivy. It's not like, you know, within a little bit of time, I would have just developed an immunity or anything like that. It doesn't really work that way. As I'm editing this video, I'm realizing that I haven't actually explained what's going on with poison ivy and what is actually causing the reaction. Poison ivy contains an oil called urushiol. It, by itself, is not poisonous to you. What happens is, when it gets on your skin, it binds to proteins in your skin. And your immune system comes along and it sees the urushiol bound to the protein, and it doesn't recognize it. Now at first, the very first time that you're ever exposed to poison ivy, it's just gonna kind of shrug it off and not really worry about it. Doesn't know what it is, no big deal. But as you are exposed to it more and more, your immune system will recognize it, and it will mount a defense against it, a reaction. That reaction is what causes the redness and inflammation and swelling and itchiness and all the stuff that we know about a poison ivy rash. Now, some people will say that if you are exposed to poison ivy more and more, you'll develop a tolerance to it. That is not the case. In fact, the opposite is actually true. As your immune system comes in contact with the bound protein in urushiol more, it recognizes it and it mounts a defense faster and maybe to a greater extent as well. However, there is another claim that consuming poison ivy orally can reduce your sensitivity to it. And I've read a lot of anecdotal accounts, and there's actually some scientific literature on this as well, and the results seem quite mixed. So I'm probably gonna do a more dedicated video on that subject because there's a ton of information around it and it's very interesting. So we'll do that at another point in the future. But I just wanted you to be aware of what's actually going on with poison ivy, urushiol, and the reaction on your skin. Back to the video. There is one more piece that I haven't interacted with yet that one could come into contact with, especially if they're trying to remove the vine, which is the inner bark, if they were cutting it. So I'm gonna test out that one just to be as thorough as we possibly can for this experiment. With all the other ones that we've tested so far, I've really had no idea what was gonna happen. However, for this one, I've just got a sense that this is probably gonna cause a reaction. The oil that comes out on the leaves in the summertime is probably stored in the vine when it's dormant in the winter. So if I cut into it, I'm probably gonna be interacting with it, but we have to test it to find out for sure. So let's do that right now. Here's our vine right here. I'm just gonna use my handsaw right here to cut into it. Let's do that. Okay, there we go. So that is our exposed part right there. I imagine that it's gonna be these outer portions kind of on the inner bark where we're gonna be finding most of the concentration of the oil, if I had to guess. So I'm gonna try to get my arm. Oh yep, I can feel it. Or at least I can feel that, you know, there's definitely some moisture in there. Jeez, gosh, I'm kind of worried about this one. But we're gonna be thorough. Okay, that's gonna be good. I'm honestly a little bit worried about this one. I hope that I didn't go overboard with that. You can see right here on my arm, that is where we got it on ourselves. This is on my right arm. So we'll see. We're going to find out. Okay, we'll give this one just a couple days and I'll check back in with you guys. And that'll be the last thing to find out. Is poison ivy really poisonous in the middle of winter? Okay. At this point in time, there is either a reaction or there is not. You guys ready to find out? Here we go. Let me get close for this one. Alright, are you watching? And yeah. Oh man, look at that. That looks terrible. Yeah, it got me. It got me good. What's the thing that they say, you know, don't poke the bear? I feel like I punched the bear at the end on that one. So, yeah. If you come in contact with the actual inner part of a vine, like if you cut into it, there's definitely going to be a reaction. No doubt about that. Do I regret doing this? No, I don't. I feel like we still learned a lot of really important information throughout this video. From what I found, at least for me, don't react from the buds. Don't react from the hairs. Don't react from the bark. But you do on the inside. And to me, what that means is, if you had to remove poison ivy, the winter is a far, far better time to do that than the summer. You're either gonna have to deal with all the leaves and then the vine, or just the vine itself. So if you are removing it, then be sure to be careful and, you know, exercise caution regardless when you're dealing with poison ivy. I didn't react, but that doesn't mean that someone who is extremely sensitive might not react themselves. So unfortunately, based on what we learned a little bit earlier in the video, this coming season, I probably need to be a little bit more cautious about being exposed to poison ivy. I don't know how long that's the case. I don't know how long after you've had a major reaction to it that you're gonna have an elevated response. You know, it's not gonna be forever likely. It's not like you're always just incrementally having worse and worse reactions to it. It probably does die off after a certain extent of not being exposed to it quite as much. But I can certainly see that within the coming season, I will have an elevated reaction to it. And that kind of sucks because one of my favorite chanterelle spots that I visit every single year is just crawling with poison ivy. So I'm gonna need to be extra careful then. I also have a little bit of poison ivy around my yard. So I'm gonna take advantage of what I learned for this video and I'm gonna go ahead and remove it right now in the winter time. But if you do want to find and remove poison ivy in the winter time, you need to be able to recognize it without its leaves. There is another vine that most people completely mistake for poison ivy. I'm gonna tell you all about it and how to distinguish the two in my video right here. I'm also gonna tell you why you might not need to go completely out of your way to remove poison ivy. So I hope to see you there and stay tuned for more fun experiments just like this one.